Have you ever looked at humanity from God's perspective? What has He been trying to show us, to teach us from the very beginning? In a word, love. In Greek, it's called agape, selfless, unconditional love for humanity, and through this, our Creator. Yahweh has told us over and over again not to abuse ourselves or others, but we do it anyways. All of us do. God kept it simple. He gave us 10 commandments, 10 very simple laws. Now, He gave us His law through His nation Israel. They were to provide a living example of God's love, to show the rest of us how to live a godly life. And they blew it. Oh, some kept the law outwardly, but they were only outward expressions of love and righteousness that did not come from the heart. Just duty and dry ritual without real love. Then came the most influential man in history, the living example of love, the Messiah, the Word of God made flesh. He's also the most loved and hated man in recorded history. It was our actions and inactions that brought on the need for the Messiah. We do not listen to God's written word or even look deeper than its surface meaning. Because of this, God came in the form of a man to explain it to us in person and to provide a living example for us to follow. Now, Israel did not become the living example of God's love to the rest of the world, but He chose to come to the world through Israel, the apple of His eye, His chosen people, to show them first, then the rest of the world, what God's love is all about. Yeshua came and lived amongst us as a man, taught us not just by words, but by His deeds. The results? We tortured and crucified Him, or so we thought. 3 days later, the world was changed by the empty tomb and His appearance to over 500 people before He ascended into heaven 30 days later. Now, why did God do this? Because we would not listen. Not you, not me, not one of us. God told us how to act, think, and feel. Then He came and showed us by a living example. My question to my Christian brothers and sisters is this: are you living that example? Are you talking the talk but not walking the walk? So if you don't listen, what's the difference between you and an atheist or a pagan? Nothing, and your end will be the same. But to those of you who do listen to God and try your best, there is a different end, a glorious end. But to non-believers and unprofitable servants, will you listen just a little? God loves you and hates the way you and I treat each other. Each of us is responsible for our own actions, to God and to each other. This world is too small for hate. If you listen to God, if you follow His example of love and sacrifice, you will know a peace in your soul that surpasses all understanding. The end of our world, as we know it, is coming soon. So listen, please, while there's still time.